Nataka niongee juu ya covenant wealth, utajiri wa agano. Na ninataka hili liwe fundisho litakalo kusaidia kama Mkristo hata katika maisha yako ya baadaye. Kwa sababu ni vizuri tujue ya kwamba Mungu who deal, God deals with all human beings. He relates to men on the basis of covenant. God relates to men on the basis of covenant. Yeah? A covenant obviously is an agreement or a transaction between men or entered between God and man. A covenant is a transaction. It is an agreement that has been entered between God and man. Praise the name of the living God. And God deals with every man depending on the kind of covenant that person has entered with God. And this is very important. God deals or relates with every man on the basis of covenant. And the way God responds to you, it depends on the covenant you have entered with him. That means it is a covenant that determines how God is going to act towards you. Wealth is not given on the basis of need. It is given on the basis of right. Kuna watu wanaweza kuwa na njaa na bado akose chakula. Lakini kuna mtu anaweza kuwa na chakula mpaka anatupa. Bwana asifiwe sana. Hebu tusome pamoja katika kitabu cha Deuteronomy chapter 8:18. But remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you the ability to produce wealth, and so confirms his covenant which he swore to your forefathers, as it is today. Bwana asifiwe sana. Mungu anazungumza na wana wa Israeli ambao ndio kanisa la leo, na anawaambia kwamba that do not forget it is the Lord your God who gives you the ability. That ability is a wisdom. Praise the name of the living God. It is a skill. Ni Mungu kupatia, you know, even skill for business, the wisdom how to go about and get money. You can get it directly from God. Praise the name of the living God. He can give you the idea. He can give you the power to implement the same, so that there is no altar, there is no power that is weakening you. Bwana asifiwe sana. But let's go back to that scripture. The Bible says, the reason God is giving you the ability to make wealth is so that, so confirms the covenant. The reason he is giving them the wealth is because there is already a covenant, and the wealth is being given to affirm, to make good the covenant that was given to their forefathers. Who are the forefathers? When the Bible is referring to forefathers, it's not referring to our grandfathers. Mainly, it refers to three people. It refers to Isaac, Jacob, and Abraham. So, this covenant, the Bible says, was given to your forefathers, and I want to give you wealth. Why? So that I can confirm that covenant that I made with them. Bwana asifiwe sana. So, number one, we need to understand that wealth is not evil. Bwana asifiwe sana. Kwa sababu kama Mungu anaweza patia watu utajiri, utajiri ni mbaya. Yeah? Wealth is part of God's redemptive plan. Even in Christ Jesus, he became poor that we might become rich. It is part of God's redemptive plan. Shetani asije akakunongonezea, sio mapenzi ya Mungu uwe tajiri. Hapana. Praise the name of the living God. It is the will of God for us to receive Wealth. Praise the name of the living God. And wealth means abundance. Yeah? And abundance means without number. Mungu angetaka kupatia pesa ambazo haziwezi kuhesabika. Kwa sababu tajiri ni kuwa na abundance. Na abundance is without number. Aname without number. When something is without number, we say it is abundant. Haiwezi kuhesabika. Mungu awabariki na pesa ambazo haziwezi kuhesabika katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Bwana asifiwe sana. Kwa hivyo utajiri sio mbaya. But let me mention something about wealth. Wealth amplifies what is in you. The good or evil. There are people, you'll never see their pride because they are humbled by poverty. You never know they are proud. Lakini wakati pesa itakuja, ita amplify hiyo kiburi. Yule mtu tulikuwa nakuja hapa, unaona amekaa chini, hana shughuli, anaomba vizuri. Wakati pesa itaingia, ndio utaona anakuja kwanza anaangalia kiti hivi. Anaguzaguza hivi kama iko na vumbi, nani akalia nakalia hapa milionea. Yeah? Yaani unakuta mtu amebadilika kwa sababu kuna kitu kina amplify. Praise the name of the living God. Kama mtu wako na huruma, kuna watu hapa wako na huruma lakini hauwezi kujua. Because hata akiangalia shida yako, atakusaidia na nini. Lakini huyo mtu akishika pesa, ni sisi tutamfundisha azisaidie watu wote. Kwa sababu huruma zake zitamuongoza kusaidia wazuri na wabaya. Kwa sababu ako na moyo wa huruma, ako na moyo wa kusaidia. Sasa kile kizuri kilikuwa ndani yake, haungejua. Kilikaliwa na shida na umasikini. Lakini wakati pesa ziliingia, kinatokea. Uzuri unatokea wakati mtu amepata pesa. Ubaya unatokea. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Hallelujah. Na ndiposa unaonanga hata wazee wakipata pesa, ndio akili ya mke wa pili inakuja. Na mke wa tatu. Wakati mzee hakuwa na pesa alikuwa anakaa tu, anaenda nyumbani mapema. Tanauliza mama, huwezi nunua mahindi ya kuchoma? Tuwe tunachoma choma hapa jioni. Na ni shida tu inafanya aitishe mahindi ya kuchoma. Siku ile pesa itaingia, takuwa anakuja nyumbani saa sita. Kwa sababu kuna kitu kibaya kilikuwa ndani yake, lakini kilisongwa na shida. Wakati pesa zinakuja, zina amplify. Bwana asifiwe sana. Na kwa hivyo ni vizuri kujiuliza, what will money amplify in me? Is it good or evil? Pesa zikija, ni nini hiyo zitatoa katika maisha yangu? Na wacha ni kuambia ni challenging, hata kwetu sisi watumishi wa Mungu. Pesa inaweza kuja, iamplify ule ubaya wote ulikuwa unaficha. Unauficha na machozi na shida. Pesa ikija, inaamplify ubaya. Inaamplify your arrogance. Yani unakuwa arrogant. Siwahitaji ni mimi mnanihitaji. Na kama mtu anasikia kwenda, mlango ndio ule. Yani unakuwa arrogant. Hata mkienda nyinyi wote, bado nitahubiri na washirika wengine wakuje. Kuna mtu anaongeanga hivyo in humble beginning. Watu wanakuanga arrogant baada ya kubarikiwa, ile arrogance ilikuwa imerara. Saa hiyo inaamuka wakati mtu amebarikiwa. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Na kwa hivyo ni vizuri kumwambia Bwana, if there is any evil in me, before you bless me, uproot it in Jesus' name. Praise the name of the living God. Can somebody declare, oh Lord, if there is any evil in me, before you bless me, uproot it in Jesus' name. Because that evil can bring your downfall. It can bring your downfall. Huo ubaya ulio ndani yako, pesa zikija, basi mwanguko wako unakuja mara moja. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Lakini ni mapenzi ya Mungu kutubariki na utajiri, atimize agano alilofanya na baba zetu. Praise the name of the living God. So be confident that God is not against wealth. God is not against wealth. He is against the lust of wealth. But he is not against wealth. He desires. Praise the name of the living God. Amen. Anafurahishwa na ufanisi wa watumishi wake. Mungu anafurahi tukitembea katika ufanisi. Hebu nikupatie mfano kwa haraka. Hebu imagine kukiwa na uzuri ndani yetu alafu tufanikiwe. Hebu angalia huo ufanisi, mambo yale utafanya mambo mazuri kuanzia kwa jamii zetu, majirani, extended family, the community, the nation. The nations will feel the impact of the love of God because of the blessing of God upon our lives. Kwa hivyo Mungu angependa tufanikiwe. Lakini angetaka tufanikiwe kama hakuna ubaya. Pesa zinakuja kuamplify katika maisha yetu. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Let's go to Genesis chapter 15 from verse 1. After this, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision. Do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield, your very great reward. But Abram said, Oh, sovereign Lord, what can you give me since I remain childless? And the one who will inherit my estate is Eliezer of Damascus. And Abram said, You have given me no children, so a servant in my household will be my heir. Then the word of the Lord came to him, This man will not be your heir, but a son coming from your own body will be your heir. He took him outside and said, Look up at the heavens, count the stars, if indeed you can count them. Then he said to him, So shall your offspring be. Abraham believed the Lord, and he credited it to him as righteousness. He also said to him, I am the Lord. This is very important from verse 7. He said to him, because we are looking at the source of the covenant of wealth. Even for us as believers, this is the source of our covenant. He said to him, I am the Lord who brought you out of the Isle of the Chaldeans to give you this land to take possession of it. But Abraham said, O sovereign Lord, how can I know that I shall gain possession of it? So the Lord said to him, Bring me a heifer, a goat, and a lamb, each 3 years old, along with a dove and a young pigeon. Abraham brought all these to him, cut them into two, and arranged them in halves opposite each other. The birds, however, he did not cut in half. Then the birds of prey came down on the carcasses, but Abraham drove them away. Verse 12, as the sun was setting, Abraham fell into a deep sleep, and a thick and dreadful darkness came over him. Then the Lord said to him, Know for certain that your descendants will be strangers in a country not their own, and they will be enslaved and ill-treated 400 years. Verse 14, but I will punish the nation they serve as slaves, and afterward they will come out with great possessions. Verse 15, you, however, will go up to your forefathers in peace and be buried at a good old age. In the fourth generation, your descendants will come back here, for the sin of the Amorites has not yet reached its full measure. Verse 17, when the sun had set and darkness had fallen, a smoking brazier with a blazing torch appeared and passed between the pieces. On that day, the Lord made a covenant with Abraham and said, To your descendants, I will give this land from the river of Egypt to the great river of the Euphrates. Bwana asifiwe sana. Nataka kusema ya kwamba na kusitiza ya kwamba relationship ya Mungu na mwanadamu inategemea agano. Na vile Mungu atakavyo kutendea, itategemea uko na agano la aina gani na yeye. Praise the name of the living God. The way God, the acts of God towards me will depend the kind of covenant I have with God. Sasa hapa Mungu anakuja kwa Abraham. Wakati huwa ana mtoto. Mungu anamwambia hapana, sio Eliezer atakaye kurithi. Hapana, mimi Mungu nitakubariki na nikupatie uzao wa tumbo yako. Na Mungu akamwambia, sio hayo tu nitakayoyatenda. Ebu angalia inchi hii. Unajua Abraham alipotoka kwao, sasa ni kutembea anatembea.
Praise the name of the living God.
Ako katika inchi ya ugeni. Lakini Mungu akamwambia, inchi hii sasa mahali huko. It is a strange land to you. But this land, I will give it to you and your descendants.
Bwana asifiwe sana. Abraham akamuuliza Mungu,
hey, hili ni jambo la kushangaza. This is a strange land to me. How can I possess this land? What will be the sign? Give me a sign.
And you see, any normal human being would ask that.
Kuna mambo Mungu anaweza kukuambia. Saa zingine unatembea tu naangalia magari makubwa, Mungu anakuambia nitakupatia gari kama hiyo. Mungu anakuambia, I'll give you a factory, I'll give you an industry. I'll give you some land. I'll give you this or that. Hata wewe ungetaka kujua, na je, haya mambo Mungu naniambia yatafanyika namna gani? Because mimi ni mgeni hapa. Some of us, wealth is a stranger, even in our family.
Praise the name of the living God.
There are things that are strangers to us. Kuna mambo ambayo ni mageni kwetu. Hata katika jamii yetu, hayajawahi kuonekana.
Jina Bwana ipewe sifa. Praise the name of the living God. May God grant you and to your family that which is a stranger to you.
Kile ambacho hakijawahi kuonekana katika maisha yako, katika jamii yenu, hicho ndicho Mungu anataka akupatie katika jina la Yesu Kristo, ndio ukajue uaminifu wake.
Praise the name of the living God.
Baada ya kuchinja na kuweka zile sehemu vipande vipande viwili viwili, na wale ndege moja kando mwingine kando, what happened?
Verse 11. And when the vultures came down on the carcasses, Abraham drove them away. Bwana asifiwe sana. Abraham amechinja dhabihu yake, anataka aweke agano na Mungu, lakini kuna vultures.
Mimi naona hawa vultures ni mfano wa shetani. Every time you want to enter into a covenant with God, into an agreement with God concerning your destiny, concerning your blessing, expect opposition. Expect that there are forces you are going to fight with them. Sometimes these forces can be the warfare in your mind. Mawazo yanakuja, yanakwambia toa usitoe, fanya usifanye. Toa hiyo dhabihu, usitoe. Unakuta ya kwamba kuna vita vikali.
Praise the name of the living God. I want to tell you, it is your responsibility to chase away the vultures. God did not come to chase the vultures.
Kwa sababu Mungu anajua, me, I want to establish a covenant with you. I want to give you a sign. Sasa Abraham alipigana hizo vita. Continue finding every vulture that is hindering your sacrifice to come to the altar in the mighty name of Jesus. May you receive the grace. May all the vultures in your life be defeated. Those vultures that want to take away your sacrifice in the name of Jesus. The vultures that are resisting your sacrifice, our sacrifice, we defeat them today in the mighty name of Jesus. We defeat them in our mind, in our businesses, in our places of work. We defeat every vulture.
Praise the name of the living God.
Sometimes vultures can be your friends, people who are close to you. Unaenda unawaambia, unajua, mimi nimeamua kutolea Mungu 1,100.
Vultures wanaanza kung'ang'ana na dhabihu yako, anakuambia, oh, hata wewe ni mjinga hivyo, umeamua utajirisha wahubiri. Yaani unaanza kutupiwa maneno, unatupiwa maneno, unatupiwa maneno mpaka unasema, hey, wacha nisomeshe watoto. Praise the name of the living God. Kwa sababu umeonyeshwa kile unachofanya sio cha maana, hakifai. There will always be vultures that want to snatch your sacrifice. There are vultures that don't want you to establish a covenant with God.
Bwana asifiwe sana. Maybe some of you have not seen, but have you ever seen people bringing money here? Pesa zinakatalia kwa mkono. Yaani anakuja kutoa pesa, mkono unakataa. Demonic forces inasema hiyo pesa usiachirie kwa hiyo madhabahu.
Kwa sababu kwa kuachilia kwa hiyo madhabahu, unajiunganisha, unaestablish madhabahu mengine. Vita. Praise the name of the living God. If you did not know, I have come to tell you, it will always be a battle when you want to establish a covenant with God by giving. Praise the name of the living God. Genesis 17, 9 to 11. And God said to Abraham, as for you, you shall keep my covenant. You and your descendants after you throughout their generations. This is my covenant which you shall keep between me and you and your descendants after you. Every male child among you shall be circumcised. And you shall be circumcised in the flesh of your foreskin. And it shall be a sign of covenant between me and you. Bwana asifiwe sana. Hallelujah. God is telling Abraham that this is the covenant I'm making with you and your descendants, that every male child must be circumcised. Sasa baada ya hiyo, ni kama wakati huwa tuna, baada ya kijana na msichana kuapa, tunauliza kama wako na pete iwe ishara ya agano. Mungu akamwambia Abraham, ishara ya hii agano ni ya kwamba kila kijana katika nyumba yako atatairiwa. Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa. Mungu alikuwa anasema kupitia mwanaume nataka niweke agano, ndiye mtoto yeyote atakayezaliwa na mwanaume katika kizazi chako, basi yule mtoto atashiriki katika hili agano la utajiri. But in the New Testament, this circumcision now is not physical. Praise the name of the living God. Amen. It is spiritual. It is giving our life to Christ so that we take away the sinful nature, the flesh. Praise the name of the living God. It is the establishment of the covenant of circumcision. Let me jump to chapter 22 now. The next level of establishment of this covenant, the Bible says, now it came to pass, 22 verse 1, now it came to pass after these things that God tested Abraham and said to him, Abraham, and he said, here I am. Then he said, take now your son, your only son, Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah and offer him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains on which I shall tell you. Verse 12. And he said, do not lay your hand on the land or do anything to him. For you, now I know that you fear God, since you have not withheld your son and only son from me. Then Abraham lifted his eyes and looked, and behind him was a lamb caught in the thicket by its horn. So Abraham went and took the lamb and offered it up for a burnt offering instead of his son. And Abraham called the name of the place, the Lord will provide, as it is today, in the mountain of the Lord shall be provided. Verse 15. Then the angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time out of heaven and said, by myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this thing and have not withheld your son, your only son, blessing I will bless you, and I will multiply your descendants as the stars on the heaven, as the sand which is on the seashore. And your descendants shall possess the gates of their enemies. In your seed, all the nations of the earth shall be blessed, because you have obeyed my voice. Bwana asifiwe sana. This chapter 22 is like what we call the climax. Mungu anamwambia Abrahamu, mimi nimeapa kama Mungu ya kwamba kukubariki nitakubariki. Nimeweka agano na wewe. But I want you now to do your part. There is a part for you. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. And you see, to Abraham, to him Isaac was more precious than himself. Because for him, he was going to die. And Isaac was his future. And remember, Isaac was the answered prayer now. Yani, you pray something precious to God, and then God says, because I want to establish my covenant, the precious, the most precious thing I have given to you, I want it back. And when Abraham gave Isaac, God told him, I have seen your heart.
I am not interested with human sacrifice. I wanted to know where your heart is. Because where your heart is, praise the name of the living God. Amen. Where your treasure is, there your heart shall also be. Mahali kitu chako cha dhamana umeweka, moyo wako utakuwa pale. Mungu alikuwa anataka kukuona ya kwamba, je, Abrahamu, moyo wako uko wapi?
Jina la Bwana ipewe sifa. Ningetaka kusema ya kwamba, anybody that gets into the covenant of wealth, there is something precious in your life that God will always require. And that is why the Bible says in Psalms chapter 50 and verse 5, gather my saints together to me. Those who have made a covenant with me by sacrifice. Those are the saints now. The saints must come and establish the same covenant. And they are supposed to establish the same covenant with a sacrifice. Praise the name of the living God. Amen. They want to connect with the same covenant that was given to Abraham. And they have to do what Abraham did. They have to connect with the same with a sacrifice. Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Ukisoma katika kitabu cha Hebrews chapter 6 and verse 16 to 18. For men indeed swear by the greater, and an oath by confirmation is for them an end of all disputes. 17. For thus God, determined to show more abundantly to the heirs of promise, and the immutability of his counsel, confirmed it by an oath. Verse 18. That by two immutable things, in which it is impossible for God to lie, we might have strong consolation, who have fled for refuge to lay hold of the hope set before us. The Bible is telling us the reason God put a lot of weight in the covenant of Abraham is not because of him alone. Sisi ambao hatukuweko, ndio siku moja tukaweze kujua ya kwamba agano hili limewekwa na Mungu akaapa na yeye mwenyewe. Because kila mtu huapa na yule mkubwa ama jambo kubwa kumuliko. Hakuna jambo kubwa, hakuna mwingine mkubwa kuliko Mungu. Vitu vyote ni yeye aliumba, angeapa na nani? Aliapa na yeye mwenyewe. Akasema hakika kukubariki, nitakubariki. Galatians 3:26. Some Christians say it is the Jews who are blessed. That is what some Christians, many Christians think. Wale Wayahudi wanapigana na Wapalestina kule, watu wengi husema wao ndio wamebarikiwa na Mungu. But the Bible says, for you are all sons of God through faith in Christ Jesus. For as many of you as were baptized into Christ have put on Christ. There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither slave nor free. There is neither male nor female. For you are all one in Christ Jesus. And if you are Christ, then you are Abraham's seeds and heirs according to the promise. Praise the name of the living God. Amen. So, because God operates under a covenant, he joined or he enjoined us in the covenant through Jesus. Praise the name of the living God. May you walk in the awareness of that covenant from today in Jesus' name. Praise the name of the living God. Unajua watu wengi unaweza kufikiria ati ya kwamba utapata utajiri kwa sababu unafanya kazi sana, kwa sababu uko na shida nyingi. Mungu, kwa sababu niko na shida nyingi, utanihurumia unipatie pesa. Hapana. Watu wengi wako na shida ya pesa. Wengine kwanza umeshawahi kuona skinny people. They are dying because of hunger. Huh? Kwa sababu gani? Mungu anadeal na wanadamu only in relationship of a covenant. If there is no covenant, there is no connection. Praise the name of the living God. Na kama sisi tutabarikiwa, lazima tuwe aware kwamba tuko na agano na Mungu na ni agano la utajiri. Bwana asifiwe sana. Na tuelewe kwamba utajiri ni part of the package ya salvation, ya redemption. Mungu angeweza kutukomboa na tuache katika ulimwengu huu na dunia hii, na asitengeneze njia yetu ya kufanikiwa ili tuwe na mali ya kutumia na tuwe na ya kumtumikia. Lazima angetengeneza njia. Na hiyo njia, kama vile alisema from Genesis.
You know, you may ask, why are we referring to the covenant of wealth from Genesis? Because even our salvation, the seed of the woman was promised in Genesis chapter 3. That is when God promised about the coming of Jesus to come and deliver us. And that is why it is also in Genesis that God established a covenant of wealth. Praise the name of the living God. Because he knew that his people, they shall be blessed. That is why when we go to Deuteronomy 8:18, God says, remember, it is the Lord your God who giveth you power to make wealth, that he may confirm the covenant. The wealth now becomes a confirmation. Haijarishi kama imekaa miaka 10,000. Lakini Mungu anakuja kukubariki. Dio a confirm. Ya kwamba wewe uliye ndani ya Yesu Kristo. Sasa na wewe umekuwa enjoined katika lile agano la utajiri. Praise the name of the living God. I declare covenant wealth in your lives in the mighty name of Jesus. I declare the gates of the enemy shall not prevail. You shall possess the gates in your place of work. Your promotion is unstoppable. In the name of Jesus, in your business, your tender is unstoppable. Hakuna mtu atazuiriwa upate kazi ambayo ni yako, because the door that God opens, there is no man who can close that door. I release the covenant wealth over your life, over the church, in the name of Jesus.
Thank you for watching this program. We know it has been a blessing to you. We highly appreciate your prayers and support. To get Apostle John Kimani's messages in its whole entirety, call the numbers on your screen. God bless you.
All the days of my life, I want to gaze.